It's the National Football League, presented by EA Sports. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Indianapolis Colts. 2-1-1 teams here, each looking to move over 500. Looking up into the roof, and he muffs it. It's loose. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
Jackson on first down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Heck of a start, a 30-yard pickup on their first play from scrimmage. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Now a first carry here for Robinson.
And he'll work free from one tackle.
But that's about all as he's taken down.
He was tackled at the 46-yard line. A gain of a yard. Brings up second and 9.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They run. Robinson. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. Jackson. This is caught. It's Cooks. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. A big one there for the Jags. 18 yards, first down.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already into field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people just like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here, too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Play action. Now Jackson. And this one into the hands of DJ Shark. And down inside the 15 he goes. 11 yards there. First down.
Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, step it back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
On first down, it's Robinson. And he'll get about 3 just outside the 10, stopped at the 11.
Taken down at the 11-yard line. It's a pickup of 3.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7.
Check.
They'll run it now with Robinson. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
It's at 2 yards, and it's third down.
Here's Jackson. And that will be incomplete.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. From the gun, it's Jackson. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Jags come up empty on fourth down. And this crowd loves it as their guys hold on the opening drive.
Turnover on down.
Eason and the Colts now with a first and 10 at their own 13. First carry now for the former Badger, Jonathan Taylor. And he'll get this one up to about his 14. Credited with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And he fires one incomplete. Jordan Reed was the intended target, and it's third down.
Nowadays, quarterbacks don't mind throwing into coverage because of the confidence they have in their receivers to come down with the ball. But sometimes you have to be careful you don't get too confident and throw an interception.
Throw on third down, Eason. And that is incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. We call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Jackson now on second and 10. It's caught left side by Cooks. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 23 yards the pickup there.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Thank you.
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. A gain of 3, second down.
They did a really nice job there defensively. They strung the play out, didn't give him a cutback lane. On each play, you have guys what I call our BCR players. Guys are responsible for the bootleg, for the cutback, and for the reverse. They played that one perfectly.
And rode him right out of bounds. And he'll give it here to his running back. About 3 yards there to the 27.
Number 33.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep a defense honest.
You mean, or else he'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Jackson. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. They'll give up 6 yards there on the loss, and it'll bring up fourth down.
That's a nice clip and save sequence there defensively because they did everything as they would have wanted to. They forced a third down, blanketed the field with coverage, nowhere to go with the football, forced a dump off to the back, and even then they closed quickly and got him down behind the line of scrimmage. You name it, they did it well in that last sequence.
These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted, but I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Yeah,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. They'll get this out in a hurry to Parker, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
His pass complete to Devontae Parker. It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7 at the 28-yard line.
3-0 after 1 on EA Sports.
Jaguars 3, Colts nothing.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. They give to Taylor out of the gun. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on the run and set them down.
And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. The holding penalty and negates a good return as they'll start just past the 20. Now Jackson on first down. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
First down, Jaguars.
Jackson caught out left side by Robinson, and he'll be out of bounds but able to get it up past the 45. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville at a first down.
Now Jackson. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. Touchdown, Jaguars. A big play there. His first NFL reception goes for 6. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. From the gun is Eason. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 49. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number 1 on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back 7 on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
After the interception, here's Jackson. Looking left side, and it's complete. That he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
And the Jaguar first down.
On the run, it's Robinson. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
That is caught at the 7. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's 1st and goal. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. That sends them 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to 2nd down.
In most goal line situations, defensive tackles are just trying to hold the line, hold their ground, and let the other guys roam and make the play. But in this situation, he's able to push his way into the backfield and disrupt that play for a loss.
Now from the 9, here's 2nd and goal. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. A great effort there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Jaguars add 6 to their lead.
People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that, and wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. They're down 17-0, really needing to find that offensive spark on this drive as they have it with a first and 10.
A carry by Taylor to start the drive.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12.
Eason going to throw it out of the shotgun. Going deep here for Parker. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
And he's only hit on 2 of his first 6 passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Operating from the gun, Eason.
Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining.
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and out will come the offense as they take over. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
And now we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? Where everything is working for them. Every move they make works. It clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, but they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
Second and 10. Here's Jackson again. His throw incomplete. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after, and it's third down.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
On third down, Jackson. The open man is Shark. It's complete. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. To throw again is Jackson. Quickly to Gronkowski, that's Kahn. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm. This guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved. Call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target. Not just the first catch, first target. From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. A 14-yard touchdown. And the Jaguars add on to their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Second and 12.
They've got second and 12 from the 36. From the gun, Eason. Eason gets hit, and the ball pops free. And the Jags grab it. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. And he brings this one back, a fumble return for a Jacksonville score. This first half has been a nightmare for that offense. Defense just dominating them.
And when you're picking up the ball, picking up their mistakes, and taking it the other way and putting it in the end zone, that's a defense's dream. They're having that type of a game.
Everything that can go wrong has gone wrong for this offensive unit. And the route is on here in this first half.
Makes the score, Jaguars 31, Colts nothing.
Maybe time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Indy offense at the line and set to go.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do? When we look at the stat sheet, we go right to
the turnover differential.
Without a doubt, because when we see that, that pretty much tells the tale of the game. And I know there's still plenty of time to go, but you've got to take care of the football in order to win it.
So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Colts getting the football first, and they trail here as we are back underway in quarter number 3. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Eason and the Colts now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. 29 is Mike. Mike 29. He'll start with a give to Taylor. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just pin their ears back and get after him now.
Campbell making the catch.
Pass complete, but no gain.
No yards.
Yeah.
So you file that as unsuccessful.
Yeah, you do, don't you? Except on the stats, throwing the ball.
Get a completion.
You get a catch.
Yeah.
But still,
no
yardage. Okay.
On third down, Eason. A thrown to Parker, complete on the slant. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
41-yard line.
On first down, Jacob Eason. And he slings one that's incomplete. He was looking that time to get it to Paris Campbell, but it'll be second down.
The struggles finding open receivers continue. I don't know the last time I saw him this inconsistent throwing the football.
It would be hard to find a date when he was this inconsistent. You know, in his locker, he keeps the word poise printed on an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. He needs to find that poise right now.
He certainly does. In fact, I would suggest he laminated.
He lost four there, and it's third down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him. It's caught inside the 25. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Operating from the gun, Eason being chased out left. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Miles Jack. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time out, another touchdown. And I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you because this one's just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? Ooh. You and me trying to get to the airport. The road to be fairly clear
that
by the time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
3-yard pickup brings up second and seven.
Here to his running back, and they're able to get this one across the 35. 11 yards there, first down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
First down.
They'll throw on first down with Jackson, and that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Again on second and 10, it's Jackson. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 40. When the rookie QB gets his first touchdown pass, that's when you put in the trophy case. First career interception, that's going to be one he wants to forget.
Yeah, and he's not going to go ask for the football, right? Yeah, you can keep that one. The key for him, what does he learn from it? When he watches the tape, does he have an answer right now where he already understands what mistake he made? That's what the coaches are going to want to know, and that's what they'll grill him on and see how he grows from it.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Third quarter here in Indy. This is second and 10. They run once more with Taylor. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and 9 situation.
Brings up third down and 9.
From the gun, Eason. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
They go play action now. Jackson. Throw complete right side to Cooks. Jackson. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Jaguars.
Jackson now, and he'll let this one go deep for Chark, and this will be caught at the 30. Jackson. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big pickup of 38.
Well, he's definitely a big target out there, listed at 6'4", and he used every one of those extra inches to go up and make that catch.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Here's Jackson to throw, letting one go deep for the end zone. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty, no question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over what the penalty would do for them?
I don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And the lead will swell by one more.
Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Easton and the Colts now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Second and 6.
Again, it's Taylor. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45.
That's good for a Colts. First and
3 quarters have come and gone. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now in Indianapolis.
Colts.
And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Throwing is Eason. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked up by Josh Jones. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
That's the score, Jaguars 45, Colts nothing.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
We'll be right back.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down. The give to Taylor. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
The Colts on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 9. Eason. Got a man. It's Judy complete. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. That one for Indianapolis resulting in 15 yards and a fresh set of downs. 50-yard line. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Steps away. That's going to be caught by Judy. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a first down. First down. They'll run the toss here with Taylor. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play. So still 14 yards to go, second down. 29 is Mike. Mike 29. Here's Eason to throw. Catch made here by Campbell. 14 yards there on the pickup, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. And that's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
It's a first down following a gain of 3. Eason sets to throw it. They'll roll him out right. And this is caught at the 8. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9.
Nice game there, partner. But you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back, and he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
They'll try and run Taylor, and he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. It'll be a gain of 5, but they do keep him out of the end zone, and now it's fourth down. And goal. A field goal does you no good, so they're going to stay out there and go for it on 4th. They turn to Taylor on 4th, and he's not going to get in. They stop him at the 1, and we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Throwing is Jackson. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked up by Xavier Howard. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
First and 10, Taylor now. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. The bottom line is he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
Call that a very strong gain of 24. They'll run here with Taylor. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Second and goal from inside the 5. Again, it'll be Taylor. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. They'll look to run with Taylor. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he does get in for 6.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no 0.
It is good.
Are you? You're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle.
McCann's got it teed up.
And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. These guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
Jackson's going to throw it. He'll fire one in zone for Cooks. And this will be caught. We'll forget taking the knee. Some late gamesmanship here as they throw for a late touchdown. He has really settled in throwing the football, and that touchdown here in the fourth quarter gives him a pretty comfortable cushion.
He may be a rookie, but he's playing like fourth quarter in the QB.